Good morning and welcome to the Take Your Life Back Today show. My name is Ralf Friedrichs. I'm an addiction recovery coach, a life coach, and a host of this show, the Take Your Life Back Today show. I hope you all had a great New Year's. As I told you last week, I wasn't going to do any until after the New Year's, being that we moved, and of course, the holiday. But as we moved, everything went great, and an important thing has happened in our lives. We have moved on from maybe some people that maybe were kind of not being the best to us, meaning that they had ambitious thoughts of trying to take advantage of us, and now we are moved on from those people. For you folks that kind of know people like that in your life, maybe this will help you. But sometimes moving on means leaving people behind, and sometimes it hurts, and sometimes it's for the better. Achieving our goals is a very personal thing. We have to decide what we want from life and pursue those thoughts. But sometimes that does involve sacrifice. I'm getting ready to move. I wrote this last week, so I have moved, and I hope it will bring a lot of exciting new ventures in our lives, certainly make it a stable life, a stable home, and hopefully I'll be able to save a lot of money. But sometimes leaving people behind can be a hurtful thing, and sometimes it kind of makes you wonder if it's the right thing. Leaving those people behind, yes, is hard, but I know I'm making the right decision for my future, my wife's future, and my sister's future. There are times when we will have to move on to something new to break ties with some of the people in our lives that might be, like I said last week in another show, toxic people. And sometimes it's just a matter of letting your heart let your heart help you decide on which way to go. I had to think how to put that heart into a sentence. It's sad to think that people who no longer are close to you, that you thought were close to you, maybe have gone the direction that you didn't expect that really to happen. You felt that maybe those people were the ones that were using you, that were taking advantage of you, and sometimes the mask comes off from those people and you see the real them. Moving on does not mean not staying in touch with those people. Moving on is to take your physical being and going somewhere else. Moving on is to separate your lifestyles totally. Doesn't mean you should hate those people. Doesn't mean that you shouldn't be involved in those people's lives. But it does mean you don't want to be involved directly in their lives, maybe even live with those people. So if you are moving on, whether it's from a relationship or it's from a living arrangement like us, certainly to be respectful of those people is always the utmost important thing to do. Maybe your life becomes richer by moving on. I know with the grace of God and the power of prayer, my life will always be better to no matter what we do. But life is also better opportunity to meet other people, visit new places and try new things and working on things that are meaningful that you might have a passion for. Folks, the people who grace our lives for a short period of time or a long period of time can change rapidly, you know, and these things came true here in this particular factor. So sometimes moving on means leaving people behind. We are leaving these folks behind, not because we hate them, not because we have any ill feelings towards them, but because we need to enhance our lives. We need to live our life the way we feel it needs to be lived. The people who grace our lives in the future will be part of our lives. These days we're all busy. I mean, let's face it, we're all busy nowadays. We don't always make the time and effort to keep in touch, but we will make an effort, in my case, to keep in touch with those particular people. We mean to text people sometimes just to say good morning or a simple, you know, have a great day. That would help. But I will tell you, moving on and leaving people behind are very important factors in your life. And you need to remember that because my wife and I, we just felt that like our lives were being like sucked into a vacuum of their lifestyle. And it wasn't a lifestyle that we, not that it doesn't work for them, but it's a lifestyle that we didn't want to be part of. It's a lifestyle that was not the way we have lived in all the years we've been together. And it's a lifestyle that we needed to leave behind. So if you are moving on and leaving people behind, do not hate those people. Do not have ill feelings. Just use it as a jumping board for better in the future. Real family and real friendships survive on a few factors in life. And one of them is trust. The other one is compatibility. And when you don't have the trust and or the compatibility, it is time to move on and move forward. So achieving our goal is very important and personal thing. We have to decide what we want from life and pursue it. And what my wife and I and my sister really wanted in life is to have a home of love and peace and harmony and a somewhat Christian home. And we didn't have that there. Not to say I don't appreciate everything that the folks have done for me, but it's certainly not a lifestyle. And it was a temporary situation, and that temporary situation has come to an end. So please, if you have gone through something, whether it's a relationship or a family issue, and it's time to move on, leave those people behind, but do not forget those people, and always remember that those people were, at one point or another, important factors in your life, and treat it as such. Toxic people in our lives that we did a show on last week is totally different. Now, some of the scenarios in your lifestyle that this show is related to could have been a toxic situation, but maybe not all the people that were in that household were toxic, maybe only one person. Call me at 844-405-HELP. We can help each other take our lives back. Folks, remember God has given you 86,400 seconds to live today. What will you do with yours? Make a difference in someone's life with a simple smile and a helping hand, and also take some of those seconds to thank God for another beautiful day. I hope to God that each and every one of you have the best day of your life, but I hope and I pray that you all have a peaceful, happy, spiritual life in days ahead. And may God bless you.